Clear? I just combined them, the earlier one and this one. This one is alpha 1 minus alpha 2, so I wrote it here, the first term. The second term, I took minus common, so again alpha 1 minus alpha 2. This one I wrote like this. Now you know about this relation that I is equal. Now I is equal to psi 1 mod square plus psi 2 mod square plus psi 1, psi 2, psi 1, psi 2, and they are in mods as well. And then e to the power I alpha 1 minus alpha 2 plus e to the power minus I alpha 1 minus alpha 2. They are like this. You know about this relation. What is this relation? You know about this one from here. E power ix is cos x and this one. So I can write e to the power ix is cos x plus I sine x. What about e power minus ix? Cos x minus I sine x. If I add up the two, then this one will become e to the power ix plus e to the power minus ix, and this will be 2 cos x. This one will cancel. So cos x I can write is this by this and by 2. Clear? So I can write, what I can write for them, psi 1 and psi 2 mods. From here, I can write that what was I1 from here? I1. So from this relation, I can write that the total intensity is equal to I1 plus I2, and this one is plus 2 times I1, I2, and they are in square root and cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2. Now how this one came in? This is psi 1 mod square, so psi 1 mod square is I1. Psi 2 mod square is I2. Now this one, psi 1 is I1 square root and psi 2 is I2 square root. So I wrote them in square root combined. This one, here x is equal to alpha 1 minus alpha 2. Here x, if I put alpha 1 minus alpha 2, then 2 is coming in here. So I divide by 2 this and I multiply by 2 here. So this 2 comes in from this one and then 2 comes in this one, right? Because if I do like this, then I can write that this divide by 2 is equal to cos x. Now here is no 2, so I will divide this by 2 and I will multiply by 2. Now this one I will call is cos alpha minus 2, and this 2 will come in here. So you got something additional here for the quantum mechanical particle. Look here, the classical particle was having its intensity the sum of I1 and I2, while the quantum mechanical particle got I1, got I2, but got this additional term. And this additional term is not fixed. This one is oscillatory, cos x, it is oscillating, right? This cos is oscillating, oscillatory function. What is meant by oscillation? You see, here the amplitude is fixed. You know sin x and cos x are oscillating between minus 1 and plus 1. So here it oscillates. the amplitude, whatever the amplitude is oscillates between plus 1 and minus 1. So here we got some oscillatory component, this one. It means classical particle was having its distribution like this. What about quantum mechanical particle? Quantum mechanical particle, due to this oscillatory nature, means the intensities will be this, this, plus this. This is the additional term. The quantum mechanical particle will have its oscillation like this. That we will have a certain maximum, is it is having a certain maximum, and on this maximum our intensity will be maximum. And then oscillation means that it will oscillate like this, and it will oscillate like this, right? Means this one will be the maximum. So we have the distribution when these will be the quantum mechanical particles, and quantum mechanicals pass through the slit, then their distribution will not be like a classical particles. Their distribution will be somehow like this. Means the particles will be here, the most, the maximum probability is here. Then at this point the probability is zero, and then another probability will come in and they will decrease and then so on. So we are having our distribution of the particles somehow like this. That if we plot the x here and the psi mod square here, psi mod square is the probability density, right? Psi is a wave function. Psi is, okay, let me explain this thing a little bit more. Our psi is a wave function, and that is having the amplitude in it. When we take the square of it, psi mod square, then psi mod square will have amplitude square in it. And this psi mod square we call the probability density. If we will multiply this psi mod square with the volume, because you know density, density is something divided by the volume. If we multiply it with the volume, we will get the probability, right? So psi mod square is the probability density. You know that if I divide this in half, then this one is the replica of this one. On both sides it will be like this. So this will be the replica of this, and I can say that our probability will be somehow like this. Let's say this one is point A. This one is point A. And this one, okay, let me change the axis for this one, because then we will not be able to interpret it the right way. Okay. So here, this is point A, this is our x, which is in this direction, and let's say this is our any other point coming from here. Let's say this is point A and this is point B. And we are finding, you know that anything plotted here is having the sum of it, the integration of it. If you are finding the particle here, you will get some probability of that particle. What will be? It will be this area under the curve. Like you find that integral. What is meant by integral? Integral is the summation. Summation of what? Area under the curve. You are shading all this thing. So it is from A to B, so you are shading the area from A to B only, this area. You are finding the particle. This is sine mod square, which is the probability density. Now we will not multiply it with the volume because we are having one dimensional situation here. Our wave function is one dimensional. So we will multiply it with the length, right? We will multiply it with the length. If our wave function will be three dimensional, then we will multiply it with the volume, delta, right? So dx and this thing will be equal to, like, our sine is a function of xt and dx, this one is mod square, and this will give you the probability of finding the particle from A to B at time t. The probability of finding the particle from point A to point B. If this is point B, what is the probability of finding the particle at point B? Zero. Because here the probability density is touching zero. So the probability at this point is zero. Similarly, this one and this one, and on the other side as well. Right? On the other side is, well, this one, because it is the replica of this one on the other side. So you are giving from the Born approximation, statistical approximation is this one. Why we say statistical? Because some probability is here, some probability is here, some probability here, and so on, because this function is not in there, it's going on. So we will have statistical information about the finding the particle. Our quantum mechanical particle is not like the classical particle. They, here it is, right? It is in space, and some defined space is there, which is here. Its probability will be this plus this plus this and so on. You add up all the probabilities, and when you add up all the probabilities, you will get one. So to have this thing, what is the maximum probability? 100%. 100% is
one.
So if I say from minus infinity to plus infinity, because this way I will go to infinity in order to have the last point of this distribution, and on this side I will go to minus infinity in order to have this side as well. So if I say all the line space, along the line I am going to minus infinity, and on this side I am going to plus infinity, and then I find the sine mod square dx, then I will get, the particle will be 100% there, right? And this will be equal to 100% 1. The particle is somehow here, some portion is here, some here, some here, some here. So this is the statistical information. I will add up all this. Where is the probability maximum? Here. But there is some probability here, there is some here and so on. I will add up all the probabilities. Now this one is not ending, it is decreasing, but it is not ending. So how to end this function? I will have to go to infinity here. And this is the same on this side as well. So I will have to go to infinity on this side as well. And this is the reason that I have just found the total probability of this thing. So from minus infinity to the plus infinity, the particle is there, one. This is a classical particle. Where it is? Here. So there is no concept of probability. This is a quantum mechanical particle like electron, proton, and those. So it is found up to some extent here, some extent here, some extent here. This is one electron. But when I measure it here at this point, I get some probability. Yes, here is some, there is electron, but some probability, some portion of it I found. Means not of the particle, but the probability. Then it is some chances here, chances here, chances there. Here is maximum chance. That chance I call probability. Here is less chance, less and so on. So if I say to classical particle, I say here it is. When I say about where is quantum mechanical particle, from minus infinity to plus infinity, all this space is, the particle is here. Because its probability, you saw this one is not ending, it is going to plus infinity. On this side it is going to minus infinity, my origin is this point. So from minus infinity to plus infinity, this one. So this one is the Born statistical interpretation. Wave function itself is not having any probability. The mod square of it is the probability density. It is having only the amplitude. So it is there. Whatever measurement you do on it, it's a dynamical nature. You will have to do measurement on this one in order to get some information about the state of the particle. Clear? And with this, thank you.